Hi kids, now you are going to learn about peasants revolts. In this one, first you should know about what is the meaning of the peasant. Peasant means, already I told, cultivators. Those who are cultivating the land, they are called as the peasants. Farmers, we are using the name also farmers for the peasants, isn't it? Okay, now we'll move on to that one. The peasants, they were affected by the Jamindars. How they affected by the Jamindars? The land revenue policy which brought by the British made the Jamindars as the ownership of the land. So what the Jamindars they did, they exploited the peasants. To protect themselves from the exploitation by the Jamindars, the peasants made some revolt. That is called as the peasants' revolt. First, we will enter into the Santhal rebellion. The first revolt which can be regarded as a peasants' revolt was the Santhal rebellion, which made in the year 1855. The land near the hills of Rajmahal in Bihar was cultivated by the tribe people Santhal, who were called as the Santhal. The landlords and money lenders from the cities took advantage of their ignorance and began grabbing their lands. Because the peasant people, what they will do for the cultivating the land, they will lend the money from the others. So this one, it was very useful for the money lenders. What they did, they grabbed their lands without the peasants' knowledge. This created bitter resentment among them, leading to their armed uprising in 1855. Because of this only, the revolt, it was started in 1855. Under the belief of a divine order, around 10,000 Santhals gathered under two Santhal brothers. The two Santhal brothers named Sidhu and Kanhu. They both only became as the leader of that group, and they guided that people to how to make the, that means how to protect themselves from the Jamindars as well as from the money lenders. The rebellion assumed a formidable shape within a month. The houses of the European planters, British officers, railway engineers, Jamindars and money lenders were attacked by the peasants people. The rebellion continued till February 1956, when the rebel leaders were captured and the movement was put down with a heavy hand. The government declared the Parganas inhabited by them as Santhal Parganas, so that their lands and identity could be safeguarded from external encroachment. But the leaders, they were captured by the British people. Okay, the Sidhu and Kanhu, both, they were captured by the British people. But after that, British government, what they declared there? They declared the Parganas, that inhabited by the Santhal Parganas, Santhal, it is called as the Santhal Parganas, as well as their land, that land also, it was returned to the peasant people itself. So through this revolt, what they achieved there, they achieved at least the identity of them, identity of the people, because before that no one knows about the Santhal people, but at least they got the identity that they are the one of the tribe people who are the peasants.